Hey, Gixxerman 01 back out in the garage. Today we're going to do a quick review on the Harbor Freight $14.95 Gravity Feed HVLP paint gun. I'm going to show you guys how to set it and how to use it. If you've never used a paint gun before, this is an absolutely perfect opportunity to get into painting at home as cheap as I think you can possibly get it done. It's a good little gun. I'll kind of review it as I go, explain how it works, and how to set it up. So let's just get right to it. So let's just go over the operation real quick. You adjust your air right here, or the amount of air that you're going to use. You adjust your fan right here, and you adjust your fluid delivery right here. You trigger your air and your fluid with this trigger. You got 20-ounce cup on it. There's a little filter down in the cup if you're shooting heavy aluminums. Sometimes that filter will clog if you're shooting something that has a really large flake in it. If you're doing that, you may want to remove that filter and just make sure that you run your material through a good filter before you put it in your gun. We're going to put water in this gun, and I'm going to show you how to set the pattern on it. And then one other thing is, this has you regulate your air with this nozzle or this knob right here. I don't really set my air by that. I just kind of run it wide open, and then I adjust my air with this little regulator right here with a little water, dirt and water trap on it. And the reason I use this regulator to adjust my air is because it's got a gauge on it, and I can actually see what kind of air pressure I'm running. We're going to run about 40 pounds of air. You can run anywhere from 40 to 50 pounds of air is really all you should need to atomize material in this gun. There's a lot of things that come into play when spraying paint, viscosity, fluid delivery, atomizing air. And so you don't want to have a ton of fluid coming out of this gun if you don't have enough air to break it up. So setting those parameters is really how you get this gun to spray really well. You want to make sure that it's spraying enough material that it wets out when you're spraying. So let's just go over how to set this gun to spray with. So what we're doing here is we're going to measure the amount of fluid delivery that we're going to get in a minute. And you want to run somewhere between, I think what the gun recommended was 8 to 10 fluid ounces a minute. It's a 1.4 tip, and I think I'm going to end up somewhere around 6 fluid ounces a minute through this gun. So you want to measure what kind of fluid delivery that you're getting, and that'll help get you in the ballpark before you start spraying. We've got our fluid delivery pretty well set. We're spraying about 6 ounces a minute, but it's water, so it's going to be a little different than what paint is. So what we're going to do now, I'm going to run my fan wide open, and then I'm going to close that fan down for my atomizing air on the air cap till I just see my pattern start to close up. And that's going to get us in the ballpark of where to set that gun when we initially start spraying. So we're wide open. I seen the fan just start to close. It might be a little hard for you guys to see, but looking through the light, I can see the fan start to close. And that's going to get me in the ballpark of where my gun needs to be. I'll show you what kind of pattern you'll get if you run your fan wide open. I see a lot of guys do it. You end up with a heavy spot at the top and the bottom and nothing in the middle. And then I'll show you also, if you don't run enough atomizing air, you end up getting a heavy spot in the middle and you just don't get it's hard to get a good overlap like that. So let's just shoot it on the paper back here and take a look at what we've got right now. As you can see, it's maybe just a little heavy on the top side. Part of that's because we're shooting water through this gun. But overall, it's a pretty even pattern of water. It's a little difficult probably to see on the camera, but that pattern looks pretty good. So I'll show you what happens when you run wide open. You see a heavy spot here and a heavy spot there, and there's very little in the middle. So if you close that pattern down, I went pretty well closed. You're gonna get this one heavy spot right in the middle. And so you wanna be able to overlap your pattern. You got a heavy spot and a heavy spot here, or heavy in the middle. So 25 years of running a paint room, I can usually walk into a booth, pick up a gun, and get it pretty well set before I ever start spraying on a part, just by using what you just saw. Look at the fluid delivery and your atomizing air closing down your fan just a little bit. So we'll run her wide open again. And we closed it till it just started to close. Changed my paper towel out so we can get a good idea. I also dropped my air pressure a little bit. You'll find that you'll make fine-tune adjustments as you're spraying the gun, and as you learn to paint, you'll figure out those adjustments that you want to make. So right now, I'm running about 30. Yeah, we're running about 30 pounds of air. We're spraying water, so it doesn't take a whole lot to atomize that. It's the viscosity on water's straight water's like 17 to 19 seconds, something like that, depending on what viscosity cup you use to measure specific gravity. I think it's a Easy Zon 2 cup, runs about 17 to 19 seconds. So we'll do a little pattern, we'll spray it on the part here and show you what it should look like when you get an overlap. So when you look at this, you don't see one spot that's a lot heavier than the other. As long as we're getting good overlap, it should be a good even pattern or film thickness over your entire part. So that is basically how you set up your paint gun. If you guys have questions, feel free to hit those comments. And I'll be glad to answer any questions you have about how to set your paint gun or how to set this paint gun for what it is that you're doing, or to the best of my ability. So I hope this helps you guys set up your paint gun and feel confident in that little Harbor Freight gun. I'll put links in the description to some other paint guns that are comparable to this that I know that work just as well as this little Harbor Freight gun does. Okay guys, there you go. I geared that video to the person that's out there on the fence as to whether or not to buy one of these central pneumatic paint guns from Harbor Freight, whether or not they'd put out a good finish. I'll put a link in the description where you can see me using this paint gun to put on a show quality finish on my little GS400 motorcycle. I wouldn't be hesitant at all to buy the $14.95 paint gun from Harbor Freight. Like I said, the video was geared to the new guy just learning to paint. I hope you guys picked up some tips and tricks on how to set up your paint gun to get started painting at home. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Put it down there in the comments. Thanks for watching. Please click like and subscribe.